Welcome, welcome, and welcome to Clever Orbits. This is Lewis Brantmeyer, personal and professional dating and relationship coach and founder and CEO of Empowering Austin Now. I'm here today with Richard Futrell, PhD in cognitive science. Richard, hello.
Hello.
All right. And producer for Planet Thunder Productions, here to speak to us today about his sci-fi horror extraordinaire film called Shifter, which you can learn more about on the Indiegogo page. If you type in Indiegogo Shifter on Google, Vinnie Hogan, welcome.
Hey guys, thanks for having me on.
So, as I said, welcome.
Nice.
So tell us about, so we watched the film. I've watched it several times. Not the whole film, of course, but that first minute that you guys have up on the page. And it was pretty brutal and visceral and intense and evoked this really strong sense of disquiet in me. However, mm-hmm. Extremely well made. And, I am excited to hear more about it. Where did this idea for this film come from?
Great. Well, thanks for checking out the concept video. Yeah, so it is a idea that our writer-director, Jacob Leighton Burns, has been working on for at least 5 or 6 years. And something that really drives us is taking a second and third and fourth look at any concept that we have, and especially in particular in the sci-fi, horror, fantasy genres. So when Jacob was a huge sci-fi and time travel fan. And so when he was thinking about time travel, he was thinking, well, there's been kind of a lot of classic fish out of water stories, kind of problem solving stories. And there's kind of this reoccurring themes in time travel. But something he had never seen before, and I personally haven't seen before either, is how could time travel be fit in the world of horror? How could it be actually engaging in that way? So that's the kind of root of it, was looking at what could be a time travel film that's unlike any time travel story you've heard or seen before.
That's fascinating. We are actually, Richard and I, big fans. Well, I don't know if you would describe yourself as a big fan, but we liked Cronenberg, which is the closest
Videodrome.
I think I... Yeah, Videodrome. Crazy film. And so, it's not something that I would watch every day. But I would love to see how the experiment in sci-fi horror, so to speak, plays out. I think, if you don't mind, I'd love to discuss the contents of what we saw in that minute so far.
Sure.
Richard, what were your impressions?
So the things that leaped to mind when I watched it, the first thing that came to my mind very powerfully was similarities with Primer, and I'd be extremely interested to know if that film has influenced your direction on this. There's this general sort of sense that there's this combination of the futuristic and the scary with the old. There's this like old style analog clock. There's this very analog looking pipe going into this device that I guess the woman is in. It almost reminds me of Myst in its aesthetic, the old game. So,
mm-hmm.
Yeah, what I really want to know is how this relates to Primer.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Well, I know I can speak for Jacob and our third producer at Planet Thunder, his brother, Zachary Burns. They both grew up watching the kind of classic, I believe they're, the Hammer horror movie. So the old Frankenstein, Dracula films of, that were made decades before any of us were born. And so they've always had an appreciation for that kind of mixture of horror or fantasy or sci-fi with seemingly, almost ancient or old technology. And as far as mixing with Primer, I know one thing is that isn't really a spoiler because you can get the sense of it in the trailer, in the concept video, is that both Primer and Shifter tell a big story like time travel on a more intimate scale. And while Primer is very much kind of such an incredible like exploration of the kind of puzzle that can be created through time travel and take such a fascinating look at what would it actually be like if somebody were to create a time machine in their garage, you know, the way the early kind of computer pioneers were creating Apple out of a garage. Shifter is a bit more of a look at what would be, how would something spectacular like time travel impact and confront somebody's identity and sense of self if they were convinced that if they were dealing with kind of personal challenges as extreme isolationism or depression.
Wow, that's incredibly interesting. I don't think that angle's been done before.
Awesome. Yeah, we don't either. But yeah,
the main gruesome image, the thing that we made in the mid Lewis quotes gruesome, I guess, is you see this woman's hand dissolving. And I guess that goes to this idea of, you know, what does time travel do to your identity? If you're shifting in time, you know, maybe not all your body is shifting at the same time. It might create a profound sense of alienation, dislocation, in a way that I think has not been looked at that level of intimacy before.
Yeah, exactly. And as you saw in the Indiegogo video, that was something that inspired Jacob from the very beginning was what, you know, if you think about all of your molecules shifting in space and time, it would essentially look as if you were melting or dissolving or evaporating in the present. And, you know, obviously we can't tell, we don't know for sure, but that sounds like it could be really unpleasant.
Yeah. I'm getting chills going down my spine just listening to you describe that.
So Richard, I've always experienced you as being an aficionado for the gruesome and the vicious and the horrific. And like this combines all three very parsimoniously in an angle on time travel that I think since H.G. Wells has never really been confronted, which as you guys were saying, that the bodily embodied process and experience of time travel itself might be this horrific, visceral, painful thing and invasive and alien and alienating and disfiguring. And yeah, so it's funny, Vinny, you and I, and this might be a good place to wrap things up, like we were discussing initially, and I'm going to gesture towards it before I ask a question, but we were discussing how this gives the world at large a way to access and have a conversation about issues of social alienation and that sort of a thing. And it's funny because you come to us and our view is kind of like, well, how can we discuss more sci-fi, like esoteric philosophical sci-fi concepts through Shifter? But, you know, now that we've done that, I am curious what the social – the if there's like a social – core or something that this film is meant to say or approach or give the world like as an access to a conversation around, what would that be?
Well, I certainly don't want to put words in the mouth of the writer, Jacob, but part of why I got so excited about it and have invested myself into it after reading early drafts of the script is I feel like now more than ever, we hear about another mass shooting earlier today. And when you look at, okay, there's a million theories and opinions on why those things happen, and there's a million voices suggesting what we could do about it. But for me, at its core, when someone takes kind of a violent action towards strangers, it's because they have a sense of not belonging to the group. And so I feel like what could be really powerful about this film is whether it's a redemptive or cautionary tale about isolationism and kind of taking your own personal story, your own personal sense of self to an unhealthy extreme to where you are just convinced that the world is not for you. I feel like that's a topic that's extremely relevant right now.
That I love. I absolutely love that. So to recreate, I'm hearing that what drew you, right? And I totally got your fine-pointed respect for the writer and authorial integrity, right? for you, what attracted you was basically the desire to be having that conversation around isolation socially and to ultimately prevent harm through having people be less isolated, and especially if their body's being viscerally ripped apart by a time machine on a regular basis.
Right. Yeah. So the kind of gruesome challenge our character faces is really just like forcing her to either dig her heels into that view, that the horror element either forces her to dig her heels in deeper or push herself to create or become something totally different. Because certainly when you start to travel through time gruesomely at random against your will, whether it's up, down, or sideways, your life will never be the same.
Wow. I love it. I love it. And I look forward to seeing what happens in the film. And if you have enjoyed what you've heard here, definitely check out, as we said, the Indiegogo page, Indiegogo Shifter on Google. And please like, share, and subscribe to Clever Orbits and comment below, because we'd love to hear your thoughts on this. Vinny, it's an honor to interview you and to have you on.
Thank you. Thank you for your time.
And Richard, thank you again, always, for being on. And may all of you in the listening of this podcast not be viscerally ripped apart by a time machine in the near future.
See you on the other side.